I just wanted to be a pianist. Always it was my dream since I was a child. I live in a house with a piano, and I used to look at the piano, and that was my whole world there in front of me. So when I grew up, I just became a musician, and I tried to realize myself as well, you know, as one in Cuba. Y quería y quise realizarme como tal en Cuba. But every single step that I did toward reaching that goal, it was just, I was facing continuously with a big wall of impossibilities. And then sitting many evenings in front of the ocean, of the Malecón, I just realized that I needed to go out chasing my dreams, and I became a hunter of dreams. And I left Cuba, and I said, adios a Cuba, and came to United States, and here I realized myself as a musician, as a painter, and embedded still as an artist, because that word of artist, it encloses exactly everything that I am. No obstante, siempre estoy pensando y siempre me imagino cuándo te voy a volver a ver. And even though I am totally realized here, because here I found the recognition and the appreciation and the respect, el respeto, el reconocimiento, la apreciación, todo lo encontré aquí como un artista, de ser artista, que era lo que yo quería y lo que yo siempre he sido. Siempre me quedo pensando en el regreso, and I think, well, when I am going to be able to see you again, to see Cuba de nuevo.
There are those who make dreams into reality. However, there are also a rare few who convert realities into dreams. Pablo belongs to this rare breed of creators. He is an artist capable of transforming memories or familiar anecdotes into true pieces of art, which he narrates while playing the piano.
All the old family.
across the way, the children's carousel, a chestnut tree, the wishing well.
At times, he submerges us in images full of color and light, which become magnificent installations and draw us into intimate moments of his life. Picture this: dozens of small multicolored birds, together with the high noon sunlight, come streaming into a bedroom to pick off threads of a chenille bedspread with their beaks, to later fly to their nests in an old poplar tree by the window. Other times, he gives us a happening where he indulges his imagination, mixing music with poetry and painting. The performance thus created has Pablo singing and telling a story in the style of the traveling minstrels, accompanying himself on the piano, while a nearby easel holds his fundamental work, Rita and the Rose. Pablo moves amongst arpeggios and paintbrushes in a climate of dreams and fantasies inhabited by form and melody. To best comprehend Pablo, one must reduce oneself to simplicity. He who thinks simple thoughts can best live in imagination and confuse it with memory.
One day I went to the School of Art in my town, San Antonio de los Baños, and Escobedo was a professor of color there. And I went to visit a friend that was taking classes there. Y cuando entré, vi el trabajo, I saw the work that he was doing, one of the Velázquez reproduction. Y en ese mismo momento que yo veo lo que mi amigo estaba haciendo, in that very moment that I saw my friends doing that, yo realicé que I just want to be a painter. What an immense emotion I felt that moment when I saw what he was doing, what you were able to do with color and drawing. So I started taking classes. He was my first professor, Escobedo, in San Antonio de los Baños. Many years later, aquí en los Estados Unidos, me preguntan, bueno, ¿y cómo tú te calificas? ¿Un pintor que toca el piano o un pianista que pinta? Y ahí fue donde encontré la definición. Muchos años después, yo le dije, no, I am an artist. Yo soy un artista. poco más. Déjame que duerma, nodriza en paz. Y si llama a él, no le digas nunca que estoy. Dile que yo me he ido. Y si llama a él, no le digas nunca que estoy. Di que Alfonsina no vuelve. No eres tú quien me engaña. Quien me engaña es mi sueño.